Hello dear students, today we will discuss some of the numerical based on Z transform. Here the numerical is given, that is, determine the impulse response sequence of the discrete time LTI system defined by y of n is minus 2y n minus 1 plus y of n minus 2 is equal to x of n plus 3x into n minus 3. So here a difference equation of a discrete time LTI system is given. So for this difference equation, we are going to apply Z transform for zero initial condition. After applying Z transform for zero initial condition, for the left hand side, that is Z transform of y of n minus 2y n minus 1 plus y n minus 2, and the right hand side, Z transform of x of n plus 3x into n minus 3. So dear students, as you already know, the Z transform of y of n is y of z, so we will take y of n as y of n, and the Z transform of y of n minus 1 is z inverse y of z, that is, we here the 2 is constant, so minus 2 z inverse y of z. Similarly, Z transform of y of n minus 2 is z to the power of minus 2 into y of z, which is equal to Z transform of x of n is x of z. And similarly, Z transform of x of n minus 3 is z to the power of minus 3 x of z. So in right hand side, we will get x of z plus 3 z to the power of minus 3 into x of z. So in left hand side, we will take y of z common. After taking y of z common, we will get y of z in bracket 1 minus 2z inverse plus z to the power of minus 2. Similarly, in right hand side, we will take x of z common. After taking x of z, we will get 1 plus 3z to the power of minus 3. So now we will take y of z by x of z. So y of z by x of z is equal to 1 plus 3z inverse upon 1 plus 2z inverse plus z to the power of minus 2. So after this, what we will take, instead of z to the power of minus 3, we will take divide by z to the power of 3. Similarly, in denominator, for z inverse, we will write 1 by z, and for z to the power of minus 2, we will take 1 by z square. So after evaluating this, we will get z cube plus 3 upon z cube divided by z square plus 2z plus 1 upon z square. So after evaluating this, z square and z square get cancels. So the remaining y of z by x of z is equal to z cube plus 3 upon z into z square plus 2z plus 1. So now y of z by x of z can be written as z square upon z square minus 2z plus 1 plus 3z inverse by z minus 1 whole square. Students, we have already discussed that y of z by x of z can be written as h of z. So here y of z by x of z, we will write it as h of z. So h of z is equal to, here I will write z into z, because z square can be written as z into z upon z minus 1 whole square. That is, z square minus 2z plus 1 can be written as z minus 1 whole square plus 3z inverse. Instead of z inverse, here we will write 3z to the power of minus 2 into z upon z minus 1 whole square. Why we are writing this? Because in order to get the standard form so that we can apply the Z transform properties. So for this, we will apply the inverse Z transform of H of Z. So after applying inverse Z transform of H of Z, in the left hand side, Z inverse of H of Z is equal to z inverse of z into z upon z minus 1 whole square plus 3 z to the power of minus 2 into z upon z minus 1 whole square. We know that z inverse of h of z is h of n. So h of n is equal to z inverse of z into z upon z minus 1 whole square plus 3z inverse plus 3z inverse into plus 3z inverse into, we will write z to the power of minus 2 into z upon z minus 1 whole square. So dear students, here I have written some of the properties which we are using in this numerical. For the first time, that is for the first part, z inverse of z into z upon z minus 1 whole square can be written as n plus 1 into u of n plus 1. Here we are applying this property, that is z transform of n plus 1 into u of n plus 1 is equal to z into z upon z minus 1 whole square. Similarly, for the second part, that is z to the power of minus 2 into z upon z minus 1 whole square can be written as n minus 2 into u of n minus 2. So here the impulse response h of n is equal to n plus 1 into u of n plus 1 plus 3 n minus 2 into n minus 2. So this is how we are going to find the impulse response. Now dear students, that next numerical, here I will take another numerical. Here what he has given, find the response of the time invariant system with impulse response. Here what he has given, the sequence h of n and x of n, and we have to find the response. What is response? Response nothing but output, that is y of n. Dear students, we have already discussed in the classroom, that is the output of an LTI system. The output of an LTI system, y of n is equal to convolution of input and the impulse response. So here I have taken y of n is equal to x of n into h of n. We know that when a time domain signal is converted into frequency domain by z transform, the y of n becomes y of z. Similarly, x of n, x of z, and h of n, h of z. And the convolution is replaced by the multiplication. That is, for time domain signal, now it is in frequency domain, it will be multiplied. So here given x of n is equal to 1, 2, 3 and 1. Nothing but x of 0 is 1, x of 1 is 2 and x of 2 is 3 and x of 3 is 1. That means here a finite sequence is given, that is the x of n is given. So with the help of z transform, we know that the definition is x of z is equal to n equal to 0 to 3. Why we are taking n equal to 0 to 3? Because he has given the finite sequence. That is from here the sequence is from at it exists only at n equal to 0, n equal to 1, n equal to 2 and n equal to 3. Hence I will take n equal to 0 to 3 into x of n into z to the power of minus n. After elaborating this, we will get x of 0 into z of 0 plus x of 1 into z inverse plus x of 2 into z to the power of minus 2 plus x of 3 into z to the power of minus 3. So here what x of z we will get, because x of 1 is, what is x of 0? It is 1. So I will take, instead of x of 0, I will take 1, and z to the power of 0 is also 1. So 1 into 1, 1. Then x of 1 is 2, x of 1 is 2 and z to the power of minus 1 plus 2z inverse. Similarly, x of 2 is 3, 3 into z to the power of minus 2, and x of 3 is 1 and 3 into x of 3 is 1 and 1 into z to the power of minus 3. So here I will get x of z is equal to 1 plus 2z inverse plus 3z to the power of minus 2 plus z to the power of minus 3. Similarly, in the same manner, here we will calculate for h of z from x, h of n. H of n is given, again the sequence which exists from n equal to 0 to n equal to 3. Therefore, h of z is equal to summation n equal to 0 to 3 h of n z to the power of minus 3. So here we will get h of 0 into z to the power of 0, h of 1 into z to the power of minus 1, plus h of 2 into z to the power of minus 2, plus h of 3 into z to the power of minus 3. We know that h of 0 is equal to 1, h of 1 is 2, h of 2 is 1, and h of 3 is minus 1. So we will substitute h of 0, h of 1, h of 2, and h of 3. So after substituting, we will get h of z is equal to 1 plus 2z inverse plus z to the power of minus 2 plus z minus z to the power of minus 3. So here, students, we got x of z and y of z. So what we have to determine here? The impulse response. So before, for impulse response, we need y of z. So we know that y of z is equal to x of z into h of z. So we know x of z and h of z. We will multiply this x of z and h of z, and we will get y of z is equal to 1 plus 4z inverse plus 8z to the power of minus 2 plus 8z to the power of minus 3 plus 3z to the power of minus 4 minus 2z to the power of minus 5 minus z to the power of minus 6. So now I will take this as equation number 1. And we know that by the definition of Z transform, we get y of z is equal to summation n equal to 0 to infinity y of n z to the power of minus n. So y of z is equal to, we will expand this, that is y of 0 plus y of 0 into z to the power of 0 plus y of 1 into z to the power of minus 1 plus y of 2 into z to the power of minus 2 plus y of 3 into z to the power of 3 plus y of 4 into z to the power of minus 4 plus y of 5 into z to the power of minus 5 plus y of 6 into z to the power of minus 6. Here I will end. Why we have to end at y of 6? Because in equation number, you can see that the y of z exists till z to the power of minus 6. Hence here I will end at z to the power of minus 6. Now I will take this as equation number 2. Now compare this equation number 1. Equation number 2 and equation number 1. After comparing equation number 1 and 2, we will get y of 0 is equal to 1, y of 1 is equal to 4, y of 2 is equal to 8, y of 3 is equal to 8, y of 4 is equal to 3, y of 5 is equal to minus 2, and y of 6 is equal to minus 1. Hence, the response of the system, that is the y of z, this is the here. Response of the system is given by y of n. Y of n is equal to 1, 4, 8, 8, 3, minus 2 and 1. And since 1 is the origin, I have taken arrow mark below the origin. We already know that where it starts, where the arrow mark determines that at this point the origin is. Hence, dear students, so far we have discussed many numericals based on the Z transform, inverse Z transform. So, dear students, I request you all to please go through once again all the numericals and also solve some of the unsolved numericals from the book so that you will be more clear. And dear students, please feel free to ask the queries through WhatsApp or through by call, because from Monday I will start the fourth unit. Thank you.